Not everybody in Alaska is a fisherman, but all of us live on salmon land. The local farmers, you know, they have little salmon streams that go through their property. If you look at a map of the Kenai Peninsula, it just looks like a cardiovascular system. Salmon are like the heartbeat.
The Salmon and People Project is a combination of understanding basic science and ecology and communicating that information to decision makers, to people, to the public. And so the whole goal of this is to understand how the ecosystems work here so that people have the option of making good decisions when they decide to do something on the landscape that won't degrade the resource. Everybody here loves salmon and they want sustainable salmon. And we hope to give them the information that will enable them to do that.
Trying to find a hole that we got last period. There was something that came alive in me when I went out fishing that I hadn't really felt before. It was being connected to something that was bigger than myself and bigger than my 23-year-old girl problems, right? And it was the first time that I really felt that I could be part of a landscape and a people that I was proud of.
My father brought up three boys hunting and fishing and not throwing stuff away and not throwing garbage down. And so we slowly kind of developed into humans that took care of those resources. When you come home from work or you go through a divorce or the normal stresses in life, when I go down to the river takes all those stresses from me. And I just don't think about other things. Watch over your shoulders for bears and enjoy that nature because you live in a place where it's available to you, where you can walk to the river from here and walk to the beach from here. And everybody in life's probably looking for their idea of this. Here, I feel it's our place to fight tooth and nail, just to keep it healthy.
Everything about salmon is exciting to me. Right now, I'm working with salmon vertebrae. And my process is gathering, processing it, and figuring out what I want to say with that material. For me, art has become so much more than object making. It's incredibly important that we feel connected because we are connected. If we lose that sense, we lose our connection to our habitat.
The last few years have been really slow in Cook Inlet. And to a certain degree, that's normal for salmon. They have big boom and bust life cycles, and as fishermen, we are really used to just riding those out. But lately, it's been really, really bad fishing. Most of our fishing days this year have been really hot, and there's a theory that fish are swimming deeper, swimming in different patterns, and so we're not intercepting them. Temperature becomes a big problem too once they get up the river. Are the rivers cold enough to sustain those juvenile salmon? So is this part of our fish run's natural cycle? Or is this related to a larger climate shift that we need to be worried about? We have more questions than answers about what's happening to our salmon here. has been nerve-wracking to watch.
My name's Kui Walker. I'm the manager of the Ketchumek Bay National Estuarine Research Reserve, and Smithsonian is funding us and helping us connect with our communities, connect the science we're doing to the communities where those decisions and that science can be useful. What we've been doing over the past years is understanding how the baby salmon, which are living in the far reaches of the watersheds, how the landscape is supporting those streams, which is supporting those juvenile salmon, which most of us have never seen before. So today what we're going to do is just sort them, ID them, and collect stomach samples so we can see what they've been eating. What they've been eating, what we've learned, is directly related to the nutrients coming off the landscape. You know, that's the message we carry out. It's like, how do we conserve the landscape so that it's still supporting the food that the salmon eat and the salmon themselves? Let's find the plumpest fish we can. We all have to understand that what we do in the landscape around these streams is having an effect on those streams, an effect on those baby salmon. People all of a sudden go, oh, I don't want to hurt salmon. I want salmon to be there for, you know, generations to come. But we have to make the right decisions as a, you know, as a group, or we won't have salmon.
So my goal in this is to see that salmon remain a sustainable resource here in Alaska. And one of the key things we've learned from this project is the linkage between the land, the wetlands, and the salmon. And if you degrade those resources, it's going to affect everything. When the water flows off of the land, it passes through the wetland before it gets to the stream, so that any kind of interaction between the water up there and the stream as it passes through the wetland will influence the ecology of the stream. When these plants die, they're going to fall over and hang over the bank of the creek, and then that becomes a source of organic matter for the creek itself. So we're going to measure that also. We have made a lot of mistakes around the world in how we've managed and changed ecosystems, and there have been huge consequences to that. We spend billions of dollars trying to fix things that we made a mess of. It would be nice to be able to take information, provide it to people so that they can still earn money, do things, but do it in a way that it's not altering the ecosystem and damaging it. And this remains one of the few places where we can do that.
You know, things are changing, and maybe permanently. Anything we can do to understand how those changes are affecting fish and how those changes are affecting the people that depend on fish will be great. More and more I've seen fishermen and scientists really working closely together and considering themselves part of the same team. That makes me think that we can weather bigger shifts as they come.
Salmon is the heart of the ecosystem here, and it's the heart of people too. So I'm just determined to do everything I can. Our partnership with the Smithsonian and the researchers are make sure that we can do whatever we can to keep things connected.
The more I realize how much resource I use, the more I realize that I should give something back. And if you don't do something up here as an individual, then eventually they'll go the way that the resources have gone other places. Then you just have a pretty place left, but nothing for fools like me to do.